Congressman Kucinich, your supporters certainly say you are different. Even your critics would probably say you are different. Here's a direct question for you.
Hello, my name is Davis Fleetwood. I'm from Groton, Massachusetts. My question is for Dennis Kucinich. After watching the first several debates, which seemed more like conversations than actual debates, we're all clear out here that you Democrats are united. We get it. But we have a very important decision to make coming up very soon, and Americans desperate for a change need to know. Congressman Kucinich, how would America be better off with you as president than we would be if either Hillary Clinton or Barack Obama became president?
What do you have that Senator Clinton and Senator Obama do not have?
Well, first of all, a clear record as having not only opposed the war from the very beginning, the only one on the stage who actually voted against the war, and also the only one on the stage who voted against funding the war 100% of the time. You know, we're here at the Citadel. I want the people of the Citadel to know that I mourn the passing of those people who gave their lives, but I also would not hesitate to call upon you to defend this country. But I'll never send you in pursuit of a political agenda or a lie. Just like my father before me, and like my who served in the Marines, and my brother who served in the Marines in Vietnam, and my nephew who served in Iraq, I believed in duty and honor, and I think it's important to have those commitments to this country. And so I say we achieve strength through peace. That's the new doctrine that I'm going to promote throughout this campaign, that we use the science of human relations and diplomacy, that we pursue an approach which says that you can use international agreements and treaties, and that you can work to settle your differences without committing the young men and women to war unless it's absolutely necessary.
Senator Clinton, you were involved in that question. I want to give you a chance to respond. 30 seconds.
Well, I think the Democrats are united, as Davis said, and we are united for change. We cannot take another 4 or 8 years of Republican leadership that has been so disastrous for our country. The issue is which of us is ready to lead on day one. I have 35 years of being an instrument and agent of change before I was ever a public official. And during the time that I've been privileged to serve as First Lady and now as Senator, I've worked to bring people together, to find common ground where we can, and then to stand our ground where we can't.
Senator Obama, you were involved in the question as well.
Oh, look, I don't think this is just a Republican problem. I think this is a problem that spans the parties. And we don't just need a change in political parties in Washington. We've got to have a change in attitudes of those who are representing the people of America. Part of the reason I don't take PAC money, I don't take federal lobbyist money, is because we've got to get the national interests up front as opposed to the special interests. And that is something that I've got a track record doing. And I think that is what the American people are looking for in this election, people of both parties as well as independents.